Steve from Utah.
Hey, McKenna. Love you. Jack, you're my hero. Sid, keep killing it, basketball.
Keep killing it.
Thanks, man.
It's the Trooper. Today is Saturday, the Las Vegas Strip. I haven't spent very much time down here over the past few months. And even though I remembered why on the way here, when road rage slid right into the back of my brain, made me yell at a couple of people, blow a few horns, that frustration that made me want to not be on the Vegas Strip reminded me of who he is. But even with that, it's pretty cool to be down here right now. I like this weather.
Let's go.
My original intention today was to go play poker in another locals casino. A little more of that local Vegas poker. But I had to come down to the Strip to see a guy about a thing. Shout out Steve. And now I'm torn. Now I don't know where I want to play poker. Maybe I want to hit the Strip. Maybe I do, maybe I don't. I will tell you this, traffic is heavy. There's a lot going on down here. Thanksgiving weekend, maybe? The day after Black Friday? Where have I not gone that is local? Red Rock? I mean, I've been to Red Rock a gazillion times. I mean, the Encore Poker Room is right over there. Venetian is over there. I would probably play Aria if I stay on the Strip. This is what I always loved about Vegas. Options. There's one thing we don't have a lot of options for, though. And I'm gonna go have that right now, even though I don't have very many options for it. You see, it is 56 degrees Fahrenheit out here today. I think yesterday was really windy, not so much today. I gotta tell you, I don't think anyone has ever missed anything more on the planet Earth than I miss the boosted board right now. Perfect boosted board weather. I was looking into it today. I think it's a gamble, but I think I can send the battery away to have it not only repaired, but have some sort of modification done to it so that anytime this particular error code comes into play again, you really gotta watch your back. You gotta watch your back on the Strip. I mean, you gotta watch your back anywhere on the planet Earth these days, but you really gotta watch your back around here. There's nothing like that coffee burn when it's cold outside and you drink a hot coffee and you let it go down a little too hot and it burns the throat. Nothing like that coffee burn in the wintertime, that is. All right, let's figure out where to play poker. Let's go. It's been a while since I played here. They have three games going. Let's give it a whirl at Resorts World. What? Played poker. We enjoy. Who is we? I went in there. I played poker. I enjoyed the game, and I won $129. I mean, we. Yeah, you guys came along for the ride or whatever. But you know, I hate when people say we. We did this. We did that. I mean, I guess I can see it a little bit. As long as you guys are the we. I will tell you a story not so much about poker, but more about poker players. When I walked in the room, they were starting a new game. I took my seat, seat eight. They play eight-handed here at Resorts World. I grabbed seat eight. I already had my chips. I sat down, and while everyone was buying their chips, I noticed a player get up from a game somewhere across the room, and he walked over to the free coffee machine, which is to about my 2 o'clock. So I can see everything that's going on over there, and the guy walks over to the machine. I don't know what the machine has. It probably has what they call cappuccino, Americano, and so on and so forth. Who knows? It's a push button, you know, grab your cup, whatever. As I look over where the guy is grabbing a cup to make himself a coffee on the complimentary coffee machine, I notice that he grabs, like, you know, when he grabs the cup, like, you know, 4 or 5 cups come up into his hand, because that's the way it always works. But instead of using his other hand to grab the cup, he used, brace yourselves, this may not seem strange to some of you, once he has his one cup and he's exited the machine, he can put this on it all he wants. In fact, it's recommended that you put it on it. He put his mouth on the cup to pull the cup off. The cups only have this much space between the rim of each cup. How is it possible? Well, how is it that he didn't touch his pokery lips to the second cup? And if that wasn't bad enough, once he pulled the cup off and put the other cups back, he put the cup down on the machine, started making his coffee, grabbed a stack of lids, and pulled one lid off of the stack. Guess what he used to do that? His mouth. Put his mouth on the lids, grabbed the lid, put the lids back on the damn thing. Here's a tip from your Uncle Trooper. Don't use the complimentary coffee machine at Resorts World. I really don't recommend it. So yeah. Interesting night of poker, disgusting coffee machine behavior on the part of poker players. Are there other disgusting people in the world? Sure. But it is in poker rooms that you will find some of the most disgusting specimens walking the planet Earth. It's dark out here, it's nighttime, it's Saturday night. Remember, if you like my videos, click the thumbs up button, make sure you subscribe, tell your friends about the videos, and leave a comment down below. Ugh, it's almost a little chilly. I'll see you next time.